Hey everybody, my name is Dan Tate. I'm right here at Fernando's Pub. I'm gonna get on that stage in a few minutes here and perform for you.
Mothers let the children ramble down the road, ranting and raving while supper's getting cold. Husbands and fathers are out getting smokes, while the lonely boy's putting cards in his spokes. Yeah, that's the way life goes. Trucker's laying miles down and he thinks about his miles. The highway signs roll by him, he wipes a tear out. And the drunkard on the corner, she dreams about her wife. Things would be much different if they hadn't had that fight. It's a fine line you have to walk if you never want to freeze. We gotta walk the walk and talk the talk. How I was shaking at the sitting on the roadside, waiting for the post. You're hoping for a letter from the one you love the most. Yeah, that's the way life goes. Yeah, that's
I grew up in a little town in Ontario, just west of Ottawa, a town called Arnprior. And I lived a lot of places in Ontario, spent a bit of time in Kingston. And when I was a raft guide, I fell in love with a woman, and then we fell out of love. So I ended up just throwing everything into the air and moving out to BC to go ski a whole bunch. So I found myself at the end of a rafting season, driving like a bum with one of my best friends across the country, and landed at Big White Ski Resort, and that was 10 years ago, this Thanksgiving.
This is a tune, this is a spicy one. This is a tune I wrote, another pandemic song. This is when it all came down and I just got back from Mexico March 12th and the lockdown came down on March 14th and I was watching my email as what was supposed to be a record year for my music just came tumbling down and cancellation after cancellation rolled in. And there was a point on the 14th or 15th where I'm like, am I doing this wrong? Or should I keep doing this? And that's kind of what this song's about. It's about that that battle. It's called Life Underwater.
Life underwater never seems to bring me what I want. Step forward, I wish to go fast. I get older. Time has a funny way of teaching us lessons, just like clouds, they make those sunny days. It's impressive. Strings pulling, and they've heard all those words I've been talking. Time, it has a funny way teaching us lessons, just like clouds they make a sunny day less impressive. All the reasons he can't solve them. Look past the mask and you'll see me. Just an artist and a man trying to break free. In time, it has a funny way of teaching us lessons. just like clouds. So they make a sunny day so less impressive. Yeah, I see time, it has a funny way of teaching us lessons. Just like clouds, they make a sunny day so less impressive. Yeah. And I can be the only one who can tell no more. And I go forward with this sinking dirt and I'll open the door.
Thank you very much. Merci. A bientôt. Take care of yourself.
Yeah. I got a couple answers. For breakfast, my favorite place to go is the Jammery. The Jammery's got great breakfast, and they have a waiting room. So if you know you got to wait for your table, you can go peruse a bunch of homemade jams and cool kitchen gadgets. And then another one of my favorite places to go is the Dream Cafe in Penticton. Fantastic live music venue and really, really great food. And then my third choice, of course, would be right here, Fernando's Pub.
I've lived elsewhere in Canada where Francophones are in a minority, and it didn't feel as open when I was in these groups. They were really closed. And I had problems integrating my non-French-speaking community with the French-speaking community that I would make, like friends or acquaintances or people from work. And here it's totally integrated.
My name is Kaylee McGuire. I am 27 years old, originally from Vernon, BC, and living in Kelowna now. I got into music at a really early age. I started singing when I could talk, apparently, and when I was six, I started singing lessons and shortly after got a guitar and just kind of kept progressing from there and singing at coffee shops and doing that whole thing.
When I came home this evening, making in my chair. Feeling it won't let me forget, and then my mind will not rest. And I guess it's just a habit, the way I behave. Because I have no excuses, nobody else to blame. This is the road I pave. This is the road I pave, and my wheels keep spinning around. Keep coming undone and fighting with myself. Well, I just get restless until I cave. There's a loneliness I cannot bear. And if I told you how I was feeling, would you still be there? Would you still be there? I just get restless until I cave. There's a loneliness I cannot bear. And if I told you how I was feeling, would you still be there? Would you still be there?
I think what's special about the community here in Kelowna is that there is something for everybody here. Like, whether you're a winter person, a summer person, you like all four seasons, there's something for everyone. So I feel like that attracts just a really, like, a good group of people. You can always find your people in, like, whatever group or setting you want to be in, whether it's on the mountain or at the beach or that kind of thing.
Streets under my feet, I walk them alone, and nobody here knows where I'm from, and I don't know where I'm going, but I might as well be a nobody. And don't it feel so free? 'Cause I'm 19 in fields of green. Sitting in the passenger seat, driving down old roads, wide enough for only you and me, and our 92 Volvo home. Well, we might as well be the only ones here, and don't you feel so free? 'Cause we're 19 in fields of green. Thatch roof houses scattered along the way. Oh, and a race in a glass full of beer, thick as molasses, to a feeling that would fade. The sea was unforgiving, and I found myself missing all the comforts back home. And I couldn't understand why it didn't go as planned, and how I could feel so alone. Somewhere we found our fairy tale, said you'd marry me on top of Lysander Hill. I was shaking, could you tell I was nervous? Could you tell into your arms I just fell? cobble streets under our feet, we walk them home.
Thank you so much for having me here. This has been really awesome. Thank you again.
My name's Sparkle, and we're at FOD Lounge. I am a local drag performer here in Kelowna. That's a typical answer, I know, but I'm the best. Something that's unique about Kelowna is it's super fun. There's something to do all year round. Like, you got the ski hill in the mountain. I don't go up there. You have the lake in the summer. You have long walks on the beach in the spring and fall. It's great.
Now that we're friends, I've decided to make you my new project.
You really don't have to do that.
I know. That's what makes me so nice. Whenever I see someone less fortunate than I, and let's face it,
who isn't?
Less fortunate than I, my tender heart tends to start to bleed. And when someone needs a makeover, I simply have to take over. I know exactly what they need. And even in your case, though it's the toughest case I've yet to face, don't worry, I'm determined to succeed. Follow my lead, and yes, indeed, you will be popular. You're gonna be popular. I'll teach you the proper poise when you talk to boys, little ways to flirt and flounce. Ooh, I'll show you what shoes to wear, how to fix your hair, everything that really counts to be popular. I'll help you be popular. You'll hang with the right cohorts. You'll be good at sports. Know the slang you've got to know. So let's start, 'cause you've got an awfully long way to go. Personality dialysis. Now that I've chosen to become a publicist or an advisor, there's nobody wiser. Not when it comes to popular. I know I'm a popular, and with an assist from me to be who you'll be instead of dreary who you were, well, are. There's nothing that can stop you from becoming popular. Lar.
Look at you. You're beautiful.
I have to go.
You're welcome.
And though you protest your disinterest, I know clandestinely you're gonna grin and bear it, your newfound popularity.
Hi, I'm Ginger Snap, and welcome to Friends of Dorothy's. I moved to Kelowna 6 years ago because I wanted to go to hair school and learn how to do hair and makeup, and then just kind of stayed here and eventually became a barber and fell in love with the drag community.
Thank you.
What's left to say? These prayers aren't working anymore. Every way shut down in flames. What's left to do with these broken pieces on the floor? I'm losing my voice, calling on you. 'Cause I've been shaking, I've been bending backwards till I'm broke. Watching all these dreams go up in smoke. Let beauty come out of ashes. Let beauty come out. I need you here. Cause I've been shaking, I've been bending backwards till I'm broke. Watching all these dreams go up in smoke. Let beauty come.
Hello, I'm Ella Lemra. I am a local drag queen in Kelowna, British Columbia, and I'm a performance artist. That's my main gig right now, and I'll be doing some lip syncs for you all today, and hopefully enjoy it, because I know I'll have a good time. My favorite thing about the drag community in Kelowna is that we essentially all grew up together, so we're all like this really nice, tight-knit family that talks and gets together and we communicate ideas. There's a few little squabbles, but that's my favorite thing, is that we grew as a community together, and I just love that.
You off the bridge.
Hi, I'm Jenna Tells, and this is Friends of Dorothy's. I'm a drag queen, but I'm also really lazy, so you won't see me after this. I think the most special part about the community here in Kelowna is we have a lot of drag queens, and some of them think they're the best, but the reality is we're all kind of mediocre. but you know, the beauty of it is that we believe we're great, and so you do too.
whatever you want. You're so fucking special. I wish I was special, but I'm a creep. I'm a widow. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. I don't belong here.
My name is Chris Dudinsky. I'm one of the partners here at Kettle River Brewing Company. What Kettle River used to be known for pre-COVID is we would have open mic once a week, we had pub trivia every Sunday, and we had an always changing beer and food menu, so there's always something new and exciting, you know, down here to come check out.
My name is Joshua Smith, and I am a local singer-songwriter, imported from the Maritimes.
This song's called My Life Can Be Beat. It's kind of a song just about, even when things are crappy, you still gotta smile, and sometimes it's just best to laugh at yourself. Especially during these times.
But spend by days in the garbage can, fighting over food with the garbage man. And I tell you, I couldn't be better, but I don't worry none with this stormy weather. Yeah, my life ain't sweet, but my life can't be beat. I see you driving in that fancy Lexus. You must have got your cash down in Oil, Texas, because I don't see many pennies, but drinks are on the house, cause I'm just that friendly. Yes. You think my life ain't sweet? Well, my life can be beat. My white teeth yellow from these cigarettes, and that bad woman I've been smoking you today. She gone and she picked me clean. She didn't leave me nothing but my favorite tea. You think that my life ain't sweet? Well, my life can't be mean. Oh, no, no, no. I have my ups and my downs, but I don't worry none with these silly frogs. You think that my life ain't sweet? But my life can't be beat. Well, my life can't be beat. Yeah, my life can't be beat.
I come from a musical family, so growing up in the Maritimes, I grew up with kitchen parties and lots of songwriter. My dad was a songwriter and producer as well, and all my family is in, are musicians as well, and I just grew up in it and wanted to be a full-time singer-songwriter, so I make my living writing songs and singing them and sharing them with people, so yeah.
So this song is called, this next one is called Waiting on the Day, and I kind of wrote this song, my dad passed away about a year ago, and I wrote this song initially about waiting on the day when I could see him again and talk to him, and as COVID went on, I realized that it kind of took on a different meaning for different people. After I released the song, people thought it was more for COVID, waiting on the day when we can all just be together again and hanging out and being regular humans. I just released the song back in January of this year. It's called Waiting on the Day.
Thank you. waiting on the day when all this goes away and I can finally hold you in my arms again. When memories are good and your name doesn't sting and every thought of you isn't bound with pain. But I'm waiting on the day when a certain kind of light creeps in through the window and I start to smile. Cause it's been so long since I saw the sun. The emptiness is thick and it lingers on. So I'll hold on. Time is so correct. I can't wait to hold you in my arms again. And this old song, I'll keep it in my chest. Cause I can't wait to hold you in my arms again. I said I'm waiting on the day when I can finally see all the things I never got to tell you. Like I believe in you, get out of your head, and you can do whatever that you want to. So I'll hold on, time is so correct. Oh, I can't wait to hold you in my arms again. This old song, I'll keep it in my chest. Cause I can't wait to hold you in my arms again. I can't wait to hold you in my arms again. This old song, I'll keep it in my chest. Oh, I can't wait to hold you in my arms again. Yeah, I'm waiting on the day when all this goes away and I can finally hold you in my arms again.
What inspires my songwriting? It's different every single day. I think for me, songwriting, some days it'll be just a melody. I'll be driving in my car, and some days I'll just have something pop into my head. But some days it'll be a line. Some days I'll be just listening to someone talking, and they'll say something that'll resonate with me. And I'll run home and grab my notepad still. I like writing things. I like pen and paper. It's random. It's every day, and I'm a random kind of person, so inspiration comes from all over the place.
Well, this song is called Hardly Love Myself, and one of the things my mom always taught me when I was a kid, she said, you got to look yourself in the mirror and tell yourself that you're wonderfully made and that you're an amazing human. That's gotten me out of a lot of depressing situations for sure. It's the hardest thing you'll ever have to do, but telling yourself that you love yourself. I wrote the song back when I didn't love myself, the song's called Hardly Love Myself.
I thought a lot before I wrote this down. Took some time before I figured it out. My heart was on a chain. Yeah, it was heading for my brain. But my love I learned to see. Even though I just made me, no pressure to perform. Yeah, and I can just be normal. Never mind. I will never settle down. Should I even bother to try and love another? I can hardly love myself. I can't love nobody else.
This town is way too big for me. My dirty lordy, it ain't hanging in the breeze. I can't live like that. I'm always looking high my back. I need a place where I can breathe. A little place where I can just be me. No pressure to perform. Oh, and I can just be normal. Yeah, right. I won't ever settle down. Should I even bother? I try another, another. I can hardly love myself. Yeah, I can't love nobody else. Stuff while she was sleeping a little. I started to drive. I didn't even say goodbye. Cause my heart will never settle down. Should I even bother? I try another, another. I can hardly love myself. Yeah, I can love nobody else. Yeah, my heart will never settle down. Should I even bother just to try love another? I can hardly love myself. I can't love nobody else. I can hardly love myself.
I'm excited to introduce to you Postmodern Connection, good friends of mine. They've been practicing and playing here for quite a long time now. I don't even want to try to summarize the style of music that they are because it's, I don't think you can quite classify it, but it's something that I and everybody's always enjoyed. So may I please present Postmodern Connection.
How will you help me die? of satisfaction in. Oh, I wrestle with my evil. Your gaze has changed so much, you fell away. Oh, you fell away from my pedestal and tried to leave, but I knew you were drunk like New Year's lovers. Mountain fades, but I've broken them.
My favorite, our favorite, well, I guess 60% of us.
Speak for yourself.
Bro.
Whoa, man.
It's our favorite yourself. Place now.
Majority of the band's favorite place to eat is Wasabi Downtown. Amazing ramen.
Wasabi ramen.
I love them. Interestingly, though, this band has like a PMC Eats where we're very particular and we rate restaurants. So they can say that they love wasabi, but I know that Steven and I love different type of ramen. The West Side has great ramen.
He's the critic of the band, though, in terms of the PMC.
We're very particular. Of course, Cam likes Italian food. We're all partial to our breweries. Jackknife makes a bomb pizza, so.
Yeah, but overall, Wasabi Ramen kind of takes the cake. Wasabi, if you're watching this, thanks for following us.
Yes. Thank you.
The multiculturalism.
The multiculturalism idea also comes heavily into the food idea too.
Definitely.
I think the most special thing about Redbird is the people that come here. They really do make it a vibe. Our music nights, the way that everybody comes together, it's been an incredible 4 years. My favorite thing is literally the patrons and the community that come here, which is why we're excited to get music started again.
Thank you so much to Redbird Brewing. Maple Fest and all you wonderful people keeping music alive during all these times. To the production team, NHP, and Jackson, everyone on the film crew, you guys are beautiful people. We really appreciate you. It's the little things in life that counts, you know? We all miss that, and this track's called Little Things, so it goes out to you guys. Thank you so much. Called is the eyes.
Our favorite maple tree? Oh God.
Treat or tree?
Treat.
Oh, tree. I'm like,
we said tree, and I was like, there's only really one maple tree.
Silver maple, hands down.
And I'm allergic to all of them.
I like the ice and the maple thing where you get the stick and then you roll it on the ice with maple syrup. And then you
eat it. Oh, that's cute.
I'm cute like that.
I've never had one of those. So
that is wicked good, though. Good call.
Dude,
what's it called again? I forget.
Maple ice.
No, that's just, yeah.
It's maple ice, bro.
It's very touristy of you.
There's another name for it.
I wouldn't know. I'm sorry.
I'm basic. My favorite is Eggo waffles with maple syrup, which is gross because I don't even like waffles and I don't like processed food. But Eggo waffles, Stranger Things, 11, I don't know, something about that.
And butter it up too.
You have to have butter. That's number one.
Maple flavored bacon?
I was gonna say that.
Oh, Thank you.